Laszlo Nemeth wasn't able to come here to Bern, so he asked me to present his slides. I didn't take part in this project, but I followed it very closely, so hopefully I can explain the key things to you. So this presentation is about LibreOffice migration, but when we want to migrate public administration or institutes to LibreOffice, it's not only means that we have to change the office suite, but we also have to add some other special applications which interact with the office suite. And I'd like to summarize the experiences that they had in this project. To put all of this in some context, there was a project in Hungary which was called the e-governmental free software competence center. It was a project sponsored by the government and by the European Union. So it was a part of the public administration operational program. So this project was planned for a 2 years period. It ran from 2011 to 2013, and six people were involved: developers, DevOps, system administrators, localizer, teacher. And at the moment, the project is in the maintenance phase, which means that the results have to be maintained for, I don't know, for 5 more years. So the books, articles, and everything that has been created by the project has to be available online, and it is. But unfortunately, people are no longer working, just to do some follow-up work, which involves also publishing a book about migrating migrating applications to the LibreOffice platform. So it's integrating applications with LibreOffice. So this book yet is in Hungarian, but the English version is also planned, and also it's interesting to notice that what they found interesting to include in this book. So I will go through the topics covered. So it's targeted to application developers in the public administration, and also to operators, so it's not for end users. So we are talking about applications which are interact with office suites. At the moment, or at the beginning of this migration process, this means Microsoft Office, so they play together with closed document formats and proprietary office suite and platform dependent libraries, Microsoft Windows dependent libraries. So this means big difficulty in migration, because these applications will not run on Linux, for example, or will not work with open standards. So the suggested solution is to have all these applications based on the open document format. shows a little code snippet, Java code snippet, which demonstrates a problem that they encountered. Under Windows, the process looked like that the application called LibreOffice and then waited for until it released the file and then took back the file. The problem is that while under Windows the file locking was a reliable method, on Linux it wasn't. So we need to handle the situation differently under Windows and Linux. So this, the selling point of Java would be that you write it once and run it everywhere, yet the application developers manage to write Windows only Java code. So these problems have to be handled accordingly. So under Windows, the system specific system code, and under Linux, the other one. And this has to be documented because application developers usually have no experience on any other system than Windows. We all know what LibreOffice is, and we know the advantages, and we are all enthusiastic about the project. However, the other people are not. So we need to explain first what LibreOffice is, and, what is it good for, and what is the document foundation, and somehow explain them the advantages of open standards and open source in general. That's why the chapter was written in this book. So the experience was that when these application developers and operators know only a little about LibreOffice project and open source, then they will not fully support the migration. So they will think that it's a central policy which was forced on them, and they will think that one day it's LibreOffice, the next day using Fubar Office, and they didn't care much about the migration project. So we need to emphasize that this is not it's not only a forced thing, but it's a good move that everyone will benefit from. So the plans, I already mentioned that an English version of this migration guide is planned. But first, the Hungarian version must be extended with more examples and more software that can handle OpenDocument and interact with LibreOffice. For example, the newest version of the Hungarian spreadsheet library can handle OpenDocument format directly, and so also has to be documented. And the next step that we'll need to write a migration guide for LibreOffice users. We want only a few hours of training was held for end users, which concentrated on the migration from Microsoft Office to LibreOffice. I wanted to tell you about this this book, and here are the names of the people who participated in writing and creating the book. And if you have any questions, then I'll try to answer.
Showed an example, a code snippet for the answer. Did I get it right that you could correct an ODT via a terminal?
You can't edit naturally, but you can at least the misspelled words,
for example. In txt file.
Yes.
And afterwards you can correct them and give it back to the ODT. There were three or five rows. Where?